Greetings everyone, I'm Darth Leon and I'm here with...
Me.
Kim, who is angry because I told him to stay on focus this time around. Alright, so...
I told you, we'll only be talking about wrestling, nothing else.
Alright, cool. So, the event. In the pre-show, well, basically, I think you didn't see it at all, right?
Yep.
Alright. But...
I saw nothing because, as you know, I stopped being into wrestling. Somehow.
Alright.
I just don't enjoy it anymore.
I asked him if he wanted to stop. He said no, he still cared for the results though. So...
But I reconsidered.
You reconsidered? This is your last one?
Yep, I'm retiring. But it will be on the finishing of this episode.
Oh. So that's going to be your angry reaction, right?
Nope. I wanted to before I was angry.
And why didn't you not tell me?
Why would I? You were accusing me of being off topic all the time. I was angry.
Oh, I see. I didn't accuse you of being all the time, but mostly all the time. So, the pre-show was an eight tag team match, because this is SmackDown, so of course we have to do this a bunch of time. The Hypers and the American Brothers, the American Alpha, defeated the Ascension and the Vaudevillains. That was pretty much it. I did not watch it, and you did not watch it at all. So let's talk about the... So I'm going to go with a different order than usual, like I usually do, order of importance or order of the pay-per-view. This time I'm going to go with a completely different order.
Okay.
Alright, so Nikki Bella defeated Carmella. So I'm guessing this is going to go for a little more while. I picked Carmella and you picked Carmella as well, if I recall correctly. We both went wrong at this one.
Actually, I told you, I think a night before, I was pretty sure Nikki would win, but I didn't change my pick.
I do remember you saying that.
You don't or you do?
No, I do. I do remember that.
Oh.
Keith Slater and Rhino defeated the Usos.
No surprise there?
Yeah. Though, again, now this brings up some complications with who's going to be the next challenger, with the whole Survivor Series thing. And Baron Corbin defeated Jack Swagger. That was the one you got against me, which you picked Baron Corbin and I went with Swagger. The match ended with an eye poke from Baron Corbin to Swagger. And last but not least, Becky Lynch was hurt, so she was unable to compete this time around. So, basically they brought out Naomi, and she defeated Alexa Bliss in like 5 minutes. Which, like, even though I like Naomi, I think that's bad for Alexa Bliss's momentum. Any comments about that?
Not really.
Alright. So, the night started with the main event, for some reason. Basically, everyone is guessing that the presentation thingy was the reason. AJ Styles...
Makes sense.
Are you being sarcastic?
I said makes sense. No, I...
Oh. Okay. So...
I mean, it's about who will be the president of America. They would probably care about not having lost the main event to that.
Alright. AJ Styles defeated Dean Ambrose and John Cena. He pinned Cena at the end. The match was actually pretty good. Everybody looked amazing. Dean Ambrose looked like the strongest fighter in the group, while John Cena looked like the strongest, even though AJ Styles seemed like the smartest. Dean Ambrose in the beginning was basically destroying everybody. he ruined everybody, and for a little while it looked like he was going to be the smart one, because he basically took like two small bumps at the very beginning, and but he was out for like 5 minutes each time.
Oh.
And you think, oh, he's doing it to be fresh at the end and let the two other guys fight it out. Nothing like that happened. The match went on for like 21 minutes, so the numbers was taking up through like 30% of it, but what 60% of it he was there, it was amazing. AJ Styles was okay, John Cena was great. Basically, the numbers looks strong, so it makes sense that he would go and face AJ Styles again at Survivor Series.
Unless something happens. Unless someone else gets the title.
In that case, it will probably be a triple threat with...
I would pay for that.
James Ellsworth. Well, I could always give you my account, even though you said that you no longer want to watch.
Well, the only match I've seen, wrestling match I've seen in the last month or a month and a half or something, it was the Ellsworth versus AJ Styles, and that says something.
That you probably...
About James Ellsworth.
Oh, about... Like...
He's a great wrestler.
Uh-huh. He almost died,
almost got into wrestling.
that's the part, not the thing that was hilarious. But the match was funny as fuck. Okay.
Thankfully he did not die, so...
Yeah, he was pretty close to it though. I made a video about it. AJ Styles remembered that shares exist. He used one on John Cena, and the reason the numbers did not like stop the pin was because I forgot the fact that AJ Styles tapped. The double tap. Basically, during like the last 4 or so minutes of the match, the numbers put AJ Styles in a submission maneuver, and John Cena, instead of breaking it up like the other two, he just went for an STF himself, which forced AJ Styles to tap out to both the submission maneuvers, which means that like the match would have ended with a tie.
If you tap to everyone, you tap to no one.
You don't tap to yourself. But yeah, there can't be two winners of a world or any championship, unless it's a tag championship, I guess. There cannot be two winners in this situation. So the
I want to make a joke, but it won't be actually wrestling related. So
go ahead.
Nah.
Okay, cool. And then he was thrown out, and the numbers got the super AA from the top, and he was unable to break the pin from AJ Styles. AJ Styles hit John Cena with a chair twice, John Cena was out, and AJ Styles took the championship with him. Basically, the match was good. It was the best match of the night, in my opinion. Anything to add?
Nope.
So, you think that since this match is first in the night, what would be the last match? Would it be
I know.
Go ahead.
Bray Wyatt versus Randy Orton.
No, that was the actual final match. Like, you'd think...
Really?
Yeah. I know you're
being... They went that way?
Yeah, they went that way. I know you're being sarcastic, but...
No, I'm not. I actually didn't know it was the last.
Oh. You'd think that the final match would be the one that has...
If you recall, you said it yourself, I didn't watch it, so how could I know
the order?
I only know the results.
I guess you would have seen it somehow else, but that doesn't matter. So you'd think the final match would be the one with a career on the line. Guess what? It wasn't. It wasn't even second to last. So...
Oh yeah, it was this match also.
Yeah.
Forgot about it.
I would like to forget about it.
I did it. It wasn't that hard.
I have another show, that's why I'm forced to remember about that, think about that. So, Ziggler versus The Miz. And Dolph won.
But guess how?
After a very, very long match.
I would say by wearing pink, but okay.
Oh yeah, that's right. You did predict that. So the match went on for 20 minutes. That's pretty long for an Intercontinental Championship match. Admittedly, the match was okay.
Oh, but the championship still exists?
Yeah, it still exists, just
but
that
Ziggler got it.
Yeah, the championship is not going to die because Ziggler got it, because considering people like Wade Barrett had it and it did not die. But it's probably going to go back to obscurity for a while, I'm guessing.
Well, I guess he won't pull the horns on you.
I mean, the Cruiserweight Championship is the best thing right now on Raw, so
right now, after how many years?
7 years.
Yeah. And who doesn't have it?
Horsangle. Horsangle is out
so
of the company,
after
so
7 years, when the Mr. Ziggler won't have it, and someone else will have it, and everyone will have forgotten about him, it will be nice title.
I have to admit something. The Miz did, like, the Dolph Ziggler getting it right now is a stupid mistake. Maybe later. Maybe after Dolph Ziggler getting built up a bit, because
it just went on the list.
It went on the list?
Mm-hmm.
What?
Yeah.
Are you making a Chris Jericho joke?
Yes.
Okay. So Dolph could have been built a little bit, because let's face it, he basically lost the last 6 pay-per-view matches he was involved in. That's
oh,
not
he was in pay-per-view matches?
Yeah, he was in pay-per-view matches. He was, did we watch it? Yeah, I'm pretty sure we watched it. We watched him fight in WrestleMania when you were here.
He was in WrestleMania?
Yeah, he was.
Really?
Do not ask me who he fought though.
Who he fought though?
Fuck you. Let's see.
Seriously, who did he fight?
WrestleMania 32.
Oh, it was Baron Corbin.
Baron Corbin debuted that night. He at the under the Giant Memorial Battle Royal. So it wasn't him. It was
the plot twist.
Let's see. He was in the ladder match for the Intercontinental Championship.
And now he won the Intercontinental Championship.
Yeah. So
and also The Miz was in that match.
Yes, he was. Wow.
And Zack Ryder was in that match.
Zack Ryder won that match.
Yeah. I'm sensing a pattern here. Who else was in that match?
Kevin Owens, who was the champion at that time. Sami Zayn.
Zayn was in that match. But now he's on Raw. Never mind.
Yeah. Stardust. Who is
Stardust was in the he's also in Raw.
No, he's not in Raw. He is at TNA.
Well, what?
Yeah.
Oh, Stardust.
Yeah, Stardust. Not Goldust. Stardust. Cody Rhodes,
yeah,
you know. And Sin Cara, who is now who is now the Hulk Hogan of the Cruiserweights.
So he's on Raw.
He is on Raw, yeah.
He could have won the belt.
Why? Why do you do you take this opportunity from Sin Cara? He may win the Cruiserweight one. So
what?
He may win the Cruiserweight one.
What? Sin Cara was in that match, and 3 of the people who were in that match won the championship in the last 6 months, so
I think it's
said
over 6 months. No, you're actually right, it's actually 6 months.
Yeah,
April is 4th, right? April is the 4th month, right?
I guess so. January, February, March, April. Who would have thought?
So
being in an Intercontinental ladder match on WrestleMania guarantees that you will get the championship if you are on the brand that has a championship.
True. So that like the three people that had the championship for like more than a day, Zack Ryder, the last three people were Dean Ambrose, Kevin Owens, and The Miz. And Dean Ambrose is my number two, and Kevin Owens is my number one. And the only person that actually did something to elevate this fucking belt is The Miz. And he fucking elevated, he made it the talk of, like, maybe, the SmackDown for sure, but...
Oh, I was about to say the talk of Smack, but okay.
You said I got it, Broken Matt Hardy. The talk of Smack. He speaks that way.
No, it's the Smack talk.
Yeah, I know, but Impact Zone, he uses the zone of impact.
You're an idiot, you know
No,
that.
You're an idiot. Dolph Ziggler is probably going to make the whole thing poof. There goes all the things that Miz did for the championship. The Intercontinental Championship.
What's that?
It's like a sort of white belt with like it's not yellow, it's like blue on it. And before it was for some reason yellow, but now it's blue and white. And The Miz has it. No, wait, Dolph Ziggler has it. The Miz had it before.
It doesn't ring any bells.
Yeah, I guess.
Sure you know who you're talking about?
Yeah. What? Yeah, I'm pretty sure.
Like, it exists.
Yeah. Like, yeah, it exists. Unfortunately, Dolph Ziggler has it right now.
No, I don't believe you. It's like inventing a belt that never exists to give it to someone.
Like the Cruiserweight Championship. Or the Women's Championship. That never existed before. But now Sasha Banks has it. Who took it from...
That's my point. Exactly. Thank you.
Like, you make a new belt and... Like, it's like nothing happened before. So, yeah, Dolph Ziggler is going to probably... Okay, maybe he will do something good with it, but you never know. It's more like he's going to get good from the belt rather than the other way around. That's the hope.
I think they will both destroy each other.
It could. So, the Spirit Squad came out at some point. That was stupid.
That is.
What?
I don't know who the Spirit Squad is.
It's two idiots. It doesn't matter.
Oh, it's two. Okay.
Yeah, it's two at this point. They used to be five. But then, like, a couple of them got lost.
Some of them died because you said spirits and...
No, not that kind of spirit, not ghosts. Like, spirits... I don't even know how to explain. So, they came out at some point. Maurice sprayed Dolph Ziggler in the face at some point. They got all thrown out. And then, Dolph Ziggler... Super kicked Miz for the win after taking two skull crushing finales and
fuck
what
he took two of these and he still survived.
Yeah, the first one he's
Dolph Ziggler, he should have died by that.
The second one he even kicked out
James Ellsworth.
The first one he put his leg on the ropes.
I know.
You know?
Mark my words, Ellsworth is going to get the Intercontinental Championship. But they don't want...
Ellsworth is not even in the roster, technically.
It doesn't matter. They just didn't want Miz to lose the title to someone who's not in the roster. So...
But if they're going to lose...
I think Kevin Owens didn't want to lose it to the Miz. That's why Zack Ryder got it, so... I'm pretty sure that we will have our first WWE World Championship plus Intercontinental Champion James Ellsworth.
No, that's the thing you're talking about, Shawn Michaels.
No, it's James Ellsworth.
No,
spelled J.
It's Shawn Michaels.
No, it's James Ellsworth. James Ellsworth.
No, Shawn Michaels did this before.
So what? James Ellsworth also did it.
Whatever. So, there was an Eddie Guerrero reference. I love Eddie Guerrero.
Yes.
Huh?
Oh, never mind then.
I hate you. Literally.
Yeah, I hate you too.
I hate you, Batista. And the match ended with a huge pop. Dolph Ziggler basically hugged everyone he could hug on his way out. He hugged...
I think you mistake him for Bailey.
No, I'm not
mistaken. I got they have long hair and they...
No, Bailey isn't at all.
One of them is a nice wrestler, a good wrestler, and the other is a dog. But...
Like, at this point you hate both of them, so I'm not sure who you're talking about. Like, is it sarcasm? Is like, are you making a joke there because you hate Bailey too?
Well, she's a heel. I'm supposed to hate her.
No, she's like, she's the definition of a baby face. Like, her face is like...
I don't believe you.
A face of a baby. So...
No, I just can't buy it. I can buy the Seth Rollins turning face, but I can't buy Bailey being face? That's... No!
Like, she's a girl that hugs people. How can that be
just
evil?
Just because the girl doesn't mean she's a face!
No. Like, she's a person that likes to hug people. Like, how do you make that evil?
You hug them really tight?
What? So the pop was huge and everybody was fucking tired after that. The arena was half
empty.
The arena was half empty, by the way,
Maybe they rage quit.
No, they did not rage quit because everybody loved it in the crowd.
I would have.
In the crowd everybody loved it. The thing is, like, it nobody cared that much about Bray Wyatt and Randy Orton. So by the point that you feel...
Oh yeah, it was that much as well.
Yeah, by the time you feel tired and like you wouldn't stay to watch that much, you would just leave and catch it at the network. Instead, like half the people left and we had this as the final match because it made no fucking sense. And people hate, like the WWE hates me. Metax, I have a quiz for you. I have a quiz for you.
I don't.
When was the last time Bray Wyatt had a match, like a singles victory against anyone in pay-per-view?
Sorry, I don't follow losers.
Sure, I'm going to accept this answer. The answer, though, is Battleground 2015. How did he, against Roman Reigns, by the way. How did he win?
Did he?
Yeah, like I just told you that he won.
Yeah, but you could be lying.
No, I did not. I'm not lying.
I don't believe you.
Anyway, he won. Just like have a guess how he won.
He cheated.
Yeah, he cheated. Like in what way?
I don't know. I don't care about losers.
Luke Harper came out and drove Roman Reigns to the ring post.
Oh.
And like he distracted Roman Reigns, so Luke Harper, like Wyatt went for the win.
Okay.
So how did Bray Wyatt win this time around against Randy Orton?
He won?
Like, yeah, he won. 13 months.
Ah.
13 months.
First Ziggler wins, then Bray wins. What the fuck is going on?
Yeah, I agree with that statement.
No wonder I gave up on wrestling.
I mean, Raw is fine. We're going to have the first women's Hell in a Cell match.
Oh. So you're just going to have two women in a cell and wait it out?
What? Okay, I'm going to move past that because it may have been a little bit like sexist, I'm not sure.
I don't care. I'm leaving the company, so...
Alright. So Luke Harper came out and he distracted Randy Orton and Bray Wyatt won the End of Days.
Yeah, he did the End of Days to Randy Orton and won.
No, he did not do the End of Days.
It's a nice move.
Alright, Metax, who uses the End of Days? Just so that I'm sure you know.
Baron Corbin?
Alright, I'm
I mean, if someone like Brandon Corbin can win using that move.
Surprised you know that, actually.
What?
Yeah, like legitimately surprised, because people that were watching NXT for a while did not know that was the name of his finisher, and like that was the only thing he did.
That's all he was saying in his promos, I will bring the end of days.
Okay, no, I'm actually happy for you.
I'm not.
No. He went for the win. Bray Wyatt won the exact same way he won his last match 50 months ago. I'm disappointed.
Well, you should be happy for the MVP.
Of the MVP?
Yeah, Luke Harper.
Yeah, I mean, I like him, but they dragged him from Raw to here because he was supposed to be in Raw. He appeared in...
Oh, he's in Raw?
He was supposed to.
Well, good for him.
He went to the good show.
Oh, wait.
He got dragged here, unfortunately.
It's not the good show anymore. I forgot.
I'm not even sure which one is the good show at this point. Yeah, I didn't not like it because it was exactly the same way it ended last time.
So the end of times. End of days. Sorry.
Yeah, the end of times.
Of the good times.
Mm-hmm. So he's in SmackDown. He's going to be forced to play second fiddle to Bray Wyatt. The match was below average. Like, very few things were worth mentioning. And the finish was stolen from last year. Anything to add?
No.
So, do you have to say, do you want to say any goodbyes to people before you leave?
Oh, yeah. So, good gentlemen and gentlewomen, I decided to leave this company because the wife and I want to have kids.
By this company, he doesn't mean he's going to leave the channel, just like this thing we're doing here.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. Exactly.
Are you stopping Payday 2? And every other game we play ever?
I'm quitting Payday, yes, but that's my thing.
Δηλαδή παρατάς το Payday.
Yeah. So, yeah, the wife and I wanted to have kids, so I can't have kids and battle an idiot over the internet. That's too exhausting for my kids, which I don't have yet, and I hope I never will. So, yeah.
But
bye-bye.
You just said that you're trying to have them, though.
Did I?
Yeah, you just said that you're leaving because you're trying to have kids.
Oh.
Yeah, you... What the... that's a plot twist right there. Plot twist. Like, that's a plot hole right there.
No.
So, I'm guessing the...
But, I'm gonna say only one thing here. That right now I'm wearing a pink shirt. And pink pants. And I've dyed my hair pink.
I need a selfie of you while you're dressed like that to put this on.
I don't want people to know how my face looks, so no.
Okay.
I can photoshop myself to look like that, but as I said, I don't want people to know how my face looks, so no.
You can put a mask on, like a sheep mask, to be like a Wyatt.
I don't follow losers.
The Wyatt family technically
That's
are not losers, just the Wyatt is
Twitter. Yeah.
So, wait, is that an actual retirement or not?
All I said is that I'm wearing a pink shirt and pink pants, and I've dyed my hair pink.
So, maybe we will see you guys at Survivor Series, maybe not. I will need to talk this out with Medax.
I won't talk to you.
Yes, you will. You talk to me like 30% of your time.
Yeah, I need to stop that.
You need to stop that?
Yeah.
Alright, so... if you want to keep following, like... I'm going to plug you. You do not mind, right?
What I do?
You do not mind if I plug my show, right?
You do what?
Like if I advertise my show here. Do you mind?
What show?
On my channel.
You have a show on your channel?
I have several, but...
And what's Darth Leon's show, the SmackDown Recount? Only on Darth Leon 13 / YouTube, the other way around.
The other way around, yeah. So, it's weekly, it's about SmackDown.
Or bi-weekly.
It's been weekly for, like, the last three weeks.
University just started, so I'm
yeah, true.
An easy way out.
True.
There's
true.
No easy way out.
Where is that from?
Nowhere.
Okay. So, I'm not doing pay-per-views there. I'm only doing them here. If this show ends, I'm not going to do them in my channel. So, maybe we'll see you guys next on Survivor Series. Or if we do not, we will probably keep uploading payday videos as well as other video games. Until then, go fuck yourselves. We are rebranding this channel into Go Fuck Yourself. G-F-Y-S?
G-F-Y.
G-F-Y? G-F-Y. This is the G-F-Y. We're going to see you guys next time.
Fuck you.
Fuck you.
And yourselves.